Hi all, I'm going to give you a quick tour of some of the new audio sync features in Deforum Studio. Deforum Studio is an AI animation generator built around the open source Deforum toolset, and it comes with a number of presets to make generating animations really easy. And what we're going to be looking at today is the event-based presets, which use events in your audio data to influence the animation at different points in time. So we're on the Create screen here, and the first thing we're going to do is switch over to audio sync mode. And I'm going to paste in a prompt I prepared earlier. And let's select a prompt style, let's say cinematic. All this really does is enhance the prompt with some extra keywords relating to that style, so it's entirely optional. And if you're happy with your prompt as is, you can just select none. And now I'm going to load in an audio file. Today I'm just using something generated with audio. And as it loads, you can see it shows the waveform and it computes the BPM. And it doesn't do too bad a job with this track. I happen to know this track is 140 BPM or 70 BPM because it's sort of a halftime beat. For many presets in Studio, this is really important because the rhythm of the animation is based entirely on the BPM detected in the audio. So if I was using one of those presets, I'd quickly go down and fix up the BPM and make sure it's nicely synced by playing with these sliders here. And I can use this indicator to make sure that it's properly on time. But today that's not so important because we're going to be using an event-based preset. Let me pick one here. Let's say the scan around one. And so I can see Studio tells me this is an event-based preset, and so it needs some events. And I can add events manually by double-clicking on the waveform or tapping this plus symbol. Then I can move them around and delete them. But I can also hit this detect button and it'll find a whole load of events for me. That actually looks like a lot, maybe too many, so I can tune down the sensitivity to filter some of the events out. And here's a little secret, this isn't documented at all and might not stick around forever. But if you don't like the results of the detection, you can hold down shift and hit detect again, and it'll use a slightly different algorithm for finding events. Technically, the default one just uses the signal amplitude, and with shift it uses the signal energy. Which one we keep in the long run will depend on how things go and on your feedback. But in this case, it's looking a bit better. I can see it's matching some of those beats just by looking at the waveform. So I'll keep those. And then just like with the tempo, I can check to see if my events are on time with the song by playing the track and watching the indicator. Then I can go in and tweak and add or move events. And another non-obvious pro tip for you here is that you can add events at the current cursor position by pressing Ctrl E. And you can do this during playback as well. So if you have a better sense of rhythm than me, you might be able to tap your events into the song as it plays. Anyway, using whichever approach you like, you can spend a bit of time getting your events just where you need them. And as you generate more videos, you'll get a better sense of what the presets do with those events, so you'll have more intuition as to where to place the events. Okay, I'm ready to generate my video, but before I do, I just want to draw your attention to this smoothing option here, which is great for reducing Deforum's trademark flicker and increasing the video consistency a bit. Technically, it'll make Studio do a secondary animate diff pass over the Deforum video before completing it. Personally, I like to use the lowest setting of the smoothing option here. Otherwise, the audio sync can go kind of a bit mushy. But for some videos, you might get really great results with the higher settings too. And now I'll hit generate. And while I wait, I can obviously browse around the other videos on the site or kick off some more of my own. And then after a few minutes, my video is ready. And here's the result with no real post-processing other than a bit of upscaling. That's all for today. Hope you enjoyed, and if you haven't taken Deforum Studio for a spin, please do give it a go.